Welcome to the dynamic world of physical education. Today, we are going to talk about one of the important topics on martial arts, that is, judo. Let us have a look, what is martial arts? Martial arts, there are more than 1,000 different forms of martial arts scattered around the world and dating back more than 2,000 years ago, when the martial arts started and where no one really knows. In our Western culture, we can date the development of martial arts such as archery and wrestling to ancient Greece. However, there is evidence that martial art training dates to Babylonian times, and the Far East development of the Oriental martial arts is a bit more difficult to understand. It is generally accepted that the martial arts developed its roots in ancient China among the monks who used a weapon, less fighting techniques to protect themselves. It is not known which type of unarmed techniques were used first, but it is clear that specialization was the custom. Combinations of different forms of fighting were unknown. Despite the ruling classes wanting to keep unarmed combat techniques secret through commerce and migration, the martial arts spread from China throughout the East. The earliest chronicle concerning the martial arts is the Nihon Shoki, which discusses Japanese wrestling and dates back to 720 AD. Since then, the martial arts had developed into a variety of systems that were the precursors of today's modern martial arts. Despite the development of many types of weaponry, unarmed combat remains still practiced all over the world. Now, let us have a look on judo's history. The origin of Japan's martial art is vague, and what we know of it is more legend than the truth. However, the Tekkenouchu Ryo martial art system, founded in 1532, is considered the beginning of Japan's jujitsu forms. The system's founder taught jujitsu in a structured and methodical manner. For the next several hundred years, the martial arts were refined by samurai who made a lifetime study of some 20 or 30 martial arts. Of these arts, only one was based on weaponless self-defense, jujitsu. By the mid-1800s, more than 700 different jujitsu systems existed. The most popular were Tekkenouchi Ryo, Jikishin Ryo, Kyushin Ryo, Yoshin Ryo, Mario Ryo, Sekiguchi Ryo, Kitu Ryo, and Tenshin Shinkyo Ryo. The last two were instrumental in judo's development. It was during this time that Japanese politics disintegrated into disarray. Commodore Perry's visit to Japan in the mid-1850s also changed the Japanese civilization by opening up a new world to them. In 1868, imperial rule was restored. Meiji Restoration and the decline of the samurai class started along with a rapid decline in all martial arts. Although the government did not officially ban the martial arts, people were not encouraged to learn or practice them, since the state was considered more important than the individual. Jiu-jitsu literally fell into disuse. What was once the glory of the samurai was now looked down on, and many well-established jiu-jitsu schools began to disappear. If the Budo concept was to survive the Meiji Restoration, it had to change and become a tool to cultivate an individual and make him a better person for the good of all. As a result, Budo found a home in physical education and sport. Sport provided teamwork, which was a good for all, and it also developed the individual. It was a complete physical education, not just a game. Although self-defense techniques were included in the training, emphasis was on using the techniques in a holistic manner. Dr. Jigoro Kano is credited with Jiu-Jitsu survival of the Meiji Restoration. He took Jiu-Jitsu and adapted it to the times. His new methodology was called Judo. In 1882, Dr. Jigoro Kano, the father of Judo, made a comprehensive study of these ancient self-defense forms and integrated the best part of these forms into a sport which is known as Kodokan Judo on the founding of Judo. In the seaside town of Mikage near Ko, Japan, Jigoro Kano was born on 28th October 1860. In 1871, Kano's family moved to Tokyo. As a boy, Kano was an undersized, slender, weak and sickly child with one sickness after another. Against his doctor's advice, Kano decided to do something to improve his health and at the same time learn how to defend himself against bullies. At the age of 18, he enrolled in the Tenjin Shinyo Ryo School of Jiu-Jitsu. Under the guidance of Fukuda Hachinosuke, Kano began his long journey to physical well-being. The Tenjin Shinyo Ryo was a soft martial arts that stressed harmony rather than combat, yet at the same time included striking and grappling techniques. After studying at the Tenjin Shinyo Ryo, Kano transferred to the Kito Ryo School to study under Likubu. This brand of Jiu-Jitsu was much softer and stressed moderate workouts with attention given to freedom of action. The abstract symbolism connected with physical technique and throwing techniques. It was during these times that Kano began a comprehensive and systematic study of other forms of Jiu-Jitsu such as Sekiguchi Ryo and Seigu Ryo. He started this project out of respect for his masters, but he carved for a mental knowledge that was lacking in their teachings. He sought to understand superior control that his teachers had mastered. He also studied the manuscripts developed by the founders of various schools, the Wan Qing Book of Changes and Lao Tzu's philosophy. Around 1880, Kano started rethinking the Jiu-Jitsu techniques he had learned. He saw that by combining the best techniques of various schools into one system, he could create a physical education program that would embody mental and physical skill. In addition, he believed that the techniques could be practiced as a competitive sport if the more dangerous techniques were omitted. So, in 1882, having pulled from ancient Jiu-Jitsu the best of its throws and grappling techniques, added some of his own and removed such dangerous techniques as foot and hand strikes. Kano, at the age of 22, presented his new sport, Judo. He called this sport Kodokan Judo. The term Kodokan breaks down into Ko, that is lecture, study, method, Do, way or path, and Kan, hall or place. Thus it means a place to study the way. Similarly, Judo breaks down into Ju, that is gentle, and Do, that is way or path, or the gentle way. Kano established his judo school called the Kodokan in the Isshoji Buddhist temple in Tokyo, which grew in size and later moved the first Kodokan head only 12 mats, 12 feet by 18 feet, and 9 students in the first year. Today, the Kodokan has over 500 mats and more than 1 million visitors a year. Kano's devotion to judo did not interfere with his academic progress. He pursued his study of literature, politics, and political economy and graduated from Tokyo Imperial University in 1881. In 1886, because of rivalry between jiu-jitsu schools and judo, a contest was held to determine the superior art. Kano's judo students won the competition easily, thus establishing the superiority of judo. Its popular principles and practical techniques. The categorization of Kodokan judo was completed about 1887. The Kodokan had three broad aims. First is physical education, contest proficiency, and mental training. Its structure as a martial art was such that it could be practiced as a competitive sport. Blows, kicks, certain joint locks, and other techniques too dangerous for competition were taught only to the higher ranks. Starting in 1881, Kano left Japan to visit Europe and the US. He traveled abroad 8 times to teach judo and several times to attend the Olympics and its committee meetings. Often, in the face of extreme hardship, several of Kano's students devoted their lives to develop judo in foreign countries. In 1892, judo began to spread its wings across the world when Takashima Shidachi lectured the Japan Society in London on the history and development of judo. In 1895, Kano classified the judo throws into the Go-Kyo no Waza. In 1900, the Kodokan Dan Grade Holders Association was established. On July 24, 1905, representatives of the leading jiu-jitsu schools, Ryo, of Japan, gathered at the Butokokai Institute in Kyoto to agree upon the forms of Kodokan Judo and to continue the development of the technical forms of the sport. The ancient jiu-jitsu technique of each particular school were to be preserved in kata, pre-arranged form, that is, for posterity. In 1907, Gunji Koizumi arrived in the United States to teach judo. In 1909, the system underwent a big change and the Kodokan became an official Japanese foundation. In the same year, Jigoro Kano became the first Japanese member of the International Olympic Committee. By 1910, judo was a recognized sport that could be safely engaged in, and in 1911, it was adopted as a part of Japan's educational system. In the same year, the Kodokan Judo Instructors Training Department, Kodokan Black Belt Association, and Japan Athletic Association were formed. Beginning with the 5th Olympiad in Stockholm, Kano attended every Olympic game and International Olympic Committee meeting and became a leading figure in international sport. Kodokan Judo underwent an evaluation by its member in 1920. The Go-Kyo no Waza was revised to include only 40 throws. 8 throws from the previous classification were discarded. In 1921, the Judo Medical Research Society was born. The Kodokan Motos Seryoko Zenyo Maximum Efficiency and Jita Hoel, that is mutual welfare and benefit, emphasize moral and spiritual training in addition to the physical training of judo. the ultimate goal of judo was to perfection the individual so that he can be of value to society. The spiritual phase developed gradually and was completed around 1922. In the same year, the Kodokan Cultural Judo Society was established. In his lifetime, Kano attained a doctorate degree in judo, a degree equivalent to the 12th Dan awarded to the originator of the judo only. He constantly worked to ensure the development of athletics and Japanese sport in general, and as a result is often called the father of Japanese sports. In 1935, he was awarded the Asahi Prize for his outstanding contribution to the organizing of sports in Japan during the lifetime. Apart from being an innovator and administrator, Kano was also a skilled player, as testified to by an high-ranking judoka who, when asked about his experience in competing against Kano, said it was like fighting with an empty jacket. A lifetime devoted to judo ended when Kano died of pneumonia abroad, the SS Hikawa Maru, on 4th May 1938, at the age of 78 years. The World War II saw a different development of judo. Instead of being used for sport, judo was being taught as a combat skill. Those selected for commando and special services training often achieved a high standard of expertise. When Japan hosted the 1964 Olympics, judo was given its first opportunity as an event. Of the 16 medals awarded for judo, Japan won 3 gold medals and 1 silver medal. Judo was no longer a Japanese sport but had developed to become an international sport. For more than 60 years, the structure of judo had not changed. In 1982, the judokan has revised Go Kyo Na Waza by reintroducing the 8 techniques that were discarded in 1920 and by adding 17 new techniques. These 65 techniques became known as the 65 techniques of Kodokan Judo. There have been 2 main developments in judo over the years. The first was the introduction of weight categories. In the early days, weight differences were not considered important. Everyone fought everyone else, with the result that if 2 players were equally matched in skill, the bigger man usually won. There was much opposition to the introduction of weight categories. Some masters feared that it meant the end of judo as a skillful art. Initially, there were 3 categories, and later this was made into 5. Inclusion of the sport in the Olympic Games in 1964 helped to hasten this important reform. The second development was the teaching of judo to children. In the early days, it was thought much too dangerous to teach children because they would not have the self-discipline to avoid using it outside the club. Today, many clubs are composed largely of junior membership. There are different styles of judo. With the inclusion in the Olympics, there has been a shift toward a contest style practice. In clubs where the style is taught, practice become largely a continuous contest. Other schools stress skills. They favor repetitive movements to make them instinctive and the development of speed through practice with little resistance. Such clubs usually also teach the kata. Such clubs could be considered traditional judo clubs. Now, let us look judo in the United States. Americans' first introduction to judo was in the late 1800s. In 1904, Yoshiaki Yamashita, one of Kano's students traveled to the US and taught his Japanese sport to Theodore Roosevelt and West Point cadets. Although many local clubs and regional associations developed, attempts to organize judo on a national basis were not successful. During the early 1930s, judo was taught at several colleges in California. In 1932, Kano lectured on judo at the University of Southern California. In the same year, four US judo associations were formed and later become recognized by the Kodokan as representatives of American judo. In 1949, Ruth Gardner became the first foreign female student to study at the Kodokan. Her objective in visiting Japan was to study for second degree black belt ranking. One of the first Japanese women to travel overseas to teach judo was Kaiko Fukuda. Now ninth Dan, she traveled to Australia and the Philippines and settled in the United States to live. It was not until after World War II that American judo began developing on a national basis. Many American servicemen studied judo in Japan during the occupation and then returned home to teach it. As a result, the Armed Forces Judo Association, AFJ, was established. American judo received a further boost in the early 1950s when General Curtis Lamey required its teaching to US Air Force and personnel in the Strategic Air Command. In 1953, judo was officially recognized as an AAU sport and national tournaments have been held since. Kano made drastic change in ancient jiu-jitsu to suit the needs of his time. The acceptance of change is inherent in judo. Everything about this martial art encourages us to make changes as required. In today's globalization of people and economy, judo will undergo tremendous change. Its adaptability lends itself to the changing needs of society and the individual. Today, judo is enjoyed by more than 4 lakh men, women, and children. There are many reasons for learning judo. Judo provides exercise, relaxation, sport, an interesting challenge, balanced coordination, self-protection, and of course, self-confidence. Judo offers a fellowship unlike other sports and develop a keen desire to coordinate mind and body. One soon realizes that sheer weight, height, strength, and age are not the governing factors of one's ability. There is a Chinese proverb, a gem cannot be polished without friction, nor men perfected without trials. So, this was all about the history of judo, from where it originated, how Kano has developed it, how the Japanese have brought this judo to us. Thank you. Have a nice day.